An historically early vote on the first part of a state budget plan is expected sometime tonight at the state capitol.
In recent years, of course, we've seen the budget battles drag on through the summer. But with Democrats now controlling the assembly and the governor's office, things have certainly changed. News 8's chief political correspondent Mark Davis live in our Hartford newsroom with more. Good evening, Mark.
Yeah, it looks like I'll get no overtime this summer. Hi, Keith and Ann. Good evening, everyone, from the Hartford newsroom. The Senate started debating the governor's budget plan about 4:30 this afternoon. But the Republicans are expected to attempt many, many amendments to derail this, amendments the Democratic leadership says will not work. In addition to the increases to the income tax for every bracket beginning at $50,000 a year, the Malloy budget plan imposes the new 6.25% sales tax on a host of items never before taxed, like non-prescription drugs, pet grooming, cosmetic surgery, and on clothing under $50. But it would not impose another 3 cents on the gas tax. Members of Malloy's own political party balked at that, and an agreement was worked out over the weekend to kill the idea. It wasn't really very hard to do, because the other tax on gasoline, the gross receipts tax, has been bringing in more and more cash to the state every week because it's a percentage of the wholesale price, which has gone up nearly every day in the past 2 months. Truckers apparently are going to lose out. The tax on diesel fuel will go up another 3 cents.
It appears now that the only ones sharing the sacrifice are those that buy diesel fuel.
But Malloy still does not have an agreement with the state labor unions on his request for $1 billion a year over the next two in concessions.
Given the fact that the budget they're asking us to vote on today is $2 billion short on being balanced, well, why don't we wait and see what the deal is that the governor has with the unions?
The governor's chief negotiator has said that a deal could be reached this week. Thousands of layoff notices could go out as soon as Friday if it is not. And there's a backup plan.
If the governor does not get an agreement or if there's a shortfall, then he gets together with the legislature. We put together the necessary cuts in the plan to balance the budget, and we as a legislature pass that.
It takes 19 votes in the 36-member state Senate for a bill to pass. The Democrats will have no trouble getting that. They'll probably get one or two more than that. The House will take it up tomorrow. Live from the Hartford newsroom, Mark Davis, News 8.